Hello, everyone. To see a list of characters, go to the blog at softlyspeakingsanskrit.com. You can also check us out on Facebook and Twitter. We hope you enjoy this twisted display of misery, confusion, and cunning.
Greetings, participants. In just a few moments, the gates will open, and we will enter the chamber.
Have you ever seen the movie Sphere, my friend? This is very much like Sphere.
I got my gloves here. Here, I'm going to give everybody a pair, because the latex, my mother said that the latex would give them an allergy.
I'm not a doctor. I have a BA in architecture.
This is pretty elaborate.
Oh my god, I deserve to go to hell.
You guys, I don't think this is hell. This looks like the New Jersey Turnpike. There's weird bats. It's awful.
No, my mother said it was pretty awful.
Does anyone have any charcoal?
Ma'am, do you want me to cut your hand off?
Yes.
I'm going to cut her hand off.
Wow, real eclectic group we've gathered here tonight, huh?
You can't just leave me.
I'm sorry, this is hell.
He's Blum. This is Blum, friend.
Who are you? What are you doing?
Help me!
That would be great.
Bro, come over here. I five. Strength in numbers.
What just happened?
I hit a person.
Whoever we were before doesn't matter here.
It's got to.
As you get up there, you see there are paths to the sides. Within a little further of his light, you can see maybe 10 feet away, you can vaguely make out paths that are going to the side again. It just starts branching, and it's silent. Dead silent here. You can't hear anything.
Where's your mom telling you to go?
Just to the light.
To the light?
Is there still a light to be seen?
His lighter is the only light.
Well, we're fucking here.
Listen, all I know is that my mother said that there was strength.
Your mother said?
Strength in numbers.
Bro, her mom ain't been wrong
yet. Okay, we got the numbers. Where the fuck we going?
Look, you remember that glowing light, bro?
Yeah, I remember that glowing light.
Straight ahead, bro. That's where it was.
It's true.
So we're just gonna go straight.
Ish.
Ish? I don't like fucking plans with ish.
But you want to make a plan then?
Yeah, I think plans in hell are just plans in hell.
How do you know we're in hell? Hell, you don't lose your fucking hand, you burn. Which I guess I don't. What the fuck are your burn marks?
Dude, I'm almost out of weed. That's a burn. You didn't high-five me. That's a burn.
I fucking high-fived you?
He did high-five you.
Oh, yeah.
I remember the other time I tried to fucking high-five you?
Yeah.
Remember how that fucking went?
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure that I'm in hell. I'm surrounded by people and things I don't understand. And I'm pretty sure that all of you want to rape me in any second right now. And all I know is that my mother is dead. And all I have left is all of her wise wisdom, because she
was a
nurse.
Wise wisdom?
She was a nurse, and nurses...
So she's the person that couldn't become a doctor.
She was a nurse, and nurses support the doctors.
Yeah, plus nurses are hot, bro.
Could not become a nurse, because, you know, it just is too unsafe.
All right, well, what are we doing?
We're going to keep going. We're going to keep going. My mother said that people with the left hand came from the devil and that we shouldn't trust things from the left. We should just keep going right.
All right. All right. Get it?
Yeah, I fucking get it.
I'm following
her. You gonna take the first right?
Sure.
All right. I'm right behind her.
It's just pitch black again. You still all have cell phones, but you're going by a lighter.
I pulled out my cell phone.
Now that he has a cell phone out, you can see much more.
Oh, shit, cell phones. I didn't think they'd work down here.
Yeah, plus you know,
batteries still work. I'm not fucking getting this signal from... Fuck you.
I didn't know, like, the devil would let you have your phone. I'm gonna call my mom. I'm gonna let my mom know I'm in hell.
There's no signal. Your mom's not.
Oh, man. There's no signal.
No.
Man, this place sucks. I guess I'll put on my flashlight app so we've got double.
You guys can see very clearly. It's maybe an 8-foot wide hallway and 8-foot ceilings running down, and there are just branches everywhere. Every maybe 10, 20 feet or so. Branch, 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 branch.
So we keep going every right one?
That is what my mother would probably say, except for I'm worried that we're going to go away from the light. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
Well, chill out right here. I'm going to hand her my bong. Just chill out. Just take a deep breath of this. We'll figure it out. It's fine.
I don't know. This.
I will light it and put it next to her mouth as she's hyperventilating.
You inhale and you feel a little calmer. It relaxes you a bit.
See, everything's going to be cool. Hey, what's your name, bro?
Thomas.
All right, Tommy. Look, where are we going?
I said Thomas.
All right, chill out, Tom.
I said Thomas.
Okay, I get it. Thomas, big fancy business dude, whatever. Where are we going? This chick's freaking out.
Fuck it, let's go to the left. She don't know what she's talking about. Sign from God, cut off my right arm. Obviously, right is wrong. Let's go fucking left.
After you, bro.
After me? No, you go first.
Nah, I'm staying with her. She's been right so far. You cool with going left?
I wish there were stars outside right now.
That doesn't do anything for us, lady.
You know, I don't know who you are.
Look, that's Tom. I'm sorry, Thomas. He's gonna get mad if I call him Tom again.
Fuck this, I'm going left.
Strength in numbers.
You turn left?
Turn left.
Need you made a speed check.
Pass.
You walk through just fine.
Alright, did I say anything?
No.
Just continue.
You just see branches and branches.
Hey, Thomas, you cool? Tommy! Tom!
It's fucking Thomas! Thomas!
Alright, he's good, let's go. Alright, well, he's fine. I'm gonna go same route.
Make a speed check.
No.
As he's walking through, he clearly steps on something.
Ugh!
The entire ceiling just collapses on him. And you two are split up.
You guys are playing wrong. I'm getting all the characters.
Does this mean left was wrong? So, I'm alone. And I suppose pop, it's okay, because I'm in hell. I'm gonna go right. Just one to the right, though, because there's lots of rights, and there's lots of lefts. I'm just going to keep going. I'm going to keep going to get to the light.
Make a navigation check.
No pass.
You wander into a room. It looks like a dead end. There's no other exits in this room. And it's just a big, maybe 15 by 15 foot room. Pretty regular for the most part. Inside, there's not much to see, but there's a giant marble dais sitting there, and on top of it, there's just this small little pool. Across all the marble, there are strange runes carved into everything.
This is kind of interesting. Maybe this will help me get to the light. I just have the flip phone, and I'm looking and scanning for anything that might be a ball of light.
Did you say flip phone?
I have a flip phone.
So you're just using the flip phone light?
I'm using a flip phone because I don't want to get access to the internet because Mother said that's where all the porn is.
No question. So you see this dull light kind of hit the room. It's kind of just glancing off the shimmering pool on top of this. There's nothing else in here. You can kind of roughly see, your eyes are attuned enough that you can roughly see all the walls. You don't really see anything else. There's just this stepped up dais, and right at the top there's just this inlet filled with some kind of liquid.
Well, I'm terribly thirsty because I'm menstruating, and I had to go pee, and I really just need some water. So, despite everything the mother has told me about not drinking water, because I know that I'm sure it's contaminated, however, I'm in hell, and I'm going to die anyways, so I might as well just quench my thirst.
Walk up the steps. You can see all these strange runes. They don't mean anything to you. But the second you touch your hands to the liquid, big fire erupts. It doesn't appear to hurt you at all. You know, this big conflagration, and it just dies down. And all of a sudden, this beam of light is just aiming just skyward. Before you even put this to your mouth, you don't feel any hunger anymore. Also, you can add one to any stat of your choice.
I'll go with navigation. Okay.
You don't feel hungry, thirsty at all. You don't even feel like you have to pee. And your menstruation seems to be lessened. Yeah, and you just see this big beam just shoot up out of it. And as you're looking up, it's almost like you have some kind of x-ray vision or something, because you can see this beam still, even somehow through the ceiling. It's just this weird connection you seem to have with it.
This obviously must be the mother and the mother of Jesus telling me that I need to continue on this journey, and then I'm going to find my way to the light.
Okay, we're going to stop with your headphones. That rubble just collapsed. You know it just flattened that guy. You're pretty sure somehow you missed something, and it hit him.
Fuck, man. Well, no way forward.
Yeah, you got one option.
I don't want to walk forward.
I need you to make a navigation check.
I got a half failure.
I don't know what half failure means.
Well, I got a one.
And a nothing. You just see a light kind of down further on. Another cell phone light. And you see a cell phone light further down also. And you hear this singing just kind of echoing off the wall here.
Hello? Hello?
Hey, man!
Hey!
Where the fuck are we?
How long have you been here?
Shit, 20 minutes!
I've been here, I think at least a week, alright?
A week?
Yeah.
What have you been doing for a week, man?
Look, I've been running, okay, like, the group I came with, they didn't last that long.
Group?
Yeah.
Who's in it?
There was this chick, and then two guys, and they ran off by the scarecrow right away, and then I just started screaming, and I ran the other way.
Shit, man, I know that.
Are you guys approaching each other?
Yeah.
Slowly. Cautiously.
No, I don't give a shit, I'm just walking home full speed. Fuck it, what's the worst thing that's gonna happen to me?
One moment! We gotta be quiet, right? We gotta be quiet right here.
Why we gotta be quiet?
There's things that are listening. They'll sneak up and get you. Look, man, I've been here a while, I know. You gotta trust me, right?
Alright.
As you approach him, could you describe yourself?
I am wearing a brown robe. It appears that I haven't bathed in a while. I probably smell pretty awful.
It's really awful. You can notice it, even with all this pungent moss and dank moisture in here.
My body is painted red. I have a tattoo on my head. My face is nestled into a giant maw of gleaming teeth.
It just looks like teeth just closing in on his face.
What the fuck's with you, man?
Look, man, don't worry about it. All right? It was.
I don't gotta worry about it. Shit, I've seen shit that's happened to me.
I was okay. Look, man, okay. I was in a gang. Four. Okay, you heard of the Warlocks?
No.
Fucking biker gang? Sacramento? No. Come on, man. Fucking Warlocks. Anyway, look. It doesn't matter anymore, man. We're down here, we gotta survive.
You ain't surviving.
Look, man, I've been here a week, alright? I hear people screaming. They've probably been here 10 minutes, they dead. Alright?
Good, but what are we gonna do?
Look, man. Follow me. You be quiet. I'll get you some food.
What kind of
food? All I've been able to find is like berries and, you know, kind of fruit. I haven't seen any meat, alright? The animals here, they're something else, man. They're not of Earth. You know what I'm saying? They're just, you ain't seen no animals, you ain't heard no animals.
I heard things. I don't fucking know what it is. Shit, man, I walk in here, get my arm chopped off. Fucking, you try listening.
His arm is cut off. You know, he's missing his hand and, you know, a couple inches of his wrist. It looks like it's been burned.
It's still bleeding a bit?
A little.
I'm gonna tear off a piece of my robe and gonna give him a tourniquet and just, here, man, here, it's gonna help cut the blood off.
Right.
Can't leave blood trail.
It feels like it's helping, but it smells awful.
Man, it smells almost as bad as you.
Look,
where
man,
we going?
I told you, man, I've been here for like a week, man. You gotta survive down here. Alright, we're gonna go down this way. I'm gonna use my navigation to get to a safe place.
Okay.
Alright, one.
Are you gonna follow him?
Sure, I'll follow him. Okay, man.
You can't tell what's going on. You're taking lefts, right, lefts, going straight, taking the next left, whatever.
How the hell do you know, man? How do you keep track of this?
Look, man. You've been here a while, you keep it in your mind. You should make mental maps. It's like road maps.
Why'd you come my way, though?
I heard some noise. I wanted to go see if there's any supplies. Some people come with different stuff, man. It helps you survive. Some people got phones, some people got food, some people got weapons.
He ends up taking you to this room, and when you get in this room, he opens the door, and in the corner, there's just this pile of green fruit.
What is that?
Man, it's food, man. It's food.
As you scan around a bit more, there's a couple other things. There's a weird knife here. It looks like it could be a great club.
Man, where'd you get these? You get these from other people?
Other people die here, man. That's what I'm saying.
There's a pile of cell phones.
You gotta
pick up a couple cell phones and also the knife.
You gotta keep your mind as razor sharp as that knife. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying. So what do we do?
Look, I've been trying to figure it out, man. I know a few things about when to run, where to go, where not to go. I'm still trying to figure this place out, though. It's huge. Right? I don't understand how this thing can be so huge. Nobody heard about this before.
Oh, girl talking about how we in hell.
This is not hell, my friend. It's like hell, but I tell you, this is not the afterlife. The afterlife is sweet release.
So what we gotta do?
How long has it been since you ate?
I don't know.
All right. Well, no, let's not eat yet, all right? We've got to keep our energy. Supplies are kind of low.
I have some diarrhea pretty soon.
You want to do that? I'll show you where you go, all right?
All right.
They don't go over there. I guess I'll start leading him there.
To diarrhea?
To where I usually use the power.
Yes. You know, he's leading, you're taking left, right, left, left, forward, whatever. You can't tell. It looks like he's just kind of randomly going around this place. And then you hear...
I'm going to hold my finger up and just don't talk, no move.
You don't hear anything. Whatever it is, you don't hear it anymore.
You know what that is?
Look, I don't know, man. There's some strange shit right here. That's what I'm saying. That's one of them. It sounds like kids eating kids. Some kind of monster.
Let's keep going, man. I got to shit real bad. Like, I almost shit myself just then. Okay?
All right. I'll keep leading him.
You get to what feels like the end of these catacombs. You open the door and you can see the light again from the outside. And you're kind of in, like, a more open area. There's no ceiling now. It's all wall after wall after wall. It's kind of a maze still, but you can now see. And as he's leading you through it, you start to hear the screaming.
I'm holding up my finger to my lips again, just quiet, and then kind of walking back into, like, the nearest shadow that I can.
Are you making a trust check?
No, I'm making a loud fart check. I'm holding in this diarrhea, this horrible shit emitting from my bowels.
Self-imposed check. You head into the shadows and wait a bit, and the screaming seems to die off. It was much louder this time.
Man, you gotta do your stuff. We gotta go, because they're close. Alright?
Alright.
He starts leading you again. Whining back and forth again. It looks, I mean, even though there's plenty of light, it just still looks like a maze. Most of it's empty, you don't really see anything. There's a bunch of bones on your way. And you get to this room. Basically, you lead him to the room you want him to diarrhea in.
Here you go.
Master Kitos.
Do it as quiet as you can, and then we go. I'm going to be right outside this door, alright?
Okay.
You doing quiet diarrhea?
Well, I'm not just like pushing. I'm like clenching. I'm doing a lot of clenching. Yeah. I'm doing burst fire.
You start hearing the screaming, and it is really close. You can't control it. There's loud noises all of a sudden. It's just bubbling and bursting. And the screaming just intensifies, and you can hear just something. You can hear something galloping towards you.
I'm clenching as
hard
as I can.
You really don't have a lot of options right now.
Yeah, I'm clenching as hard as I can, and I'm just like standing up.
Are you doing anything weird?
Okay. No, I'm standing.
Like, I'm trying to be as quiet as possible.
Okay. The wall just explodes. Stones are flying everywhere. Need you all to make speed checks.
Double sixes.
One fail and one nothing.
I just killed the one useful guy in this whole thing.
Because of your shit.
Okay. Blocks are just flying everywhere. This giant stone block just hits you in the face. You just splat across a wall. You're just sitting there just like, oh my god, as all these rocks just fly past you, and all of a sudden this giant red thing flies into the room. It's probably 10, 15 feet tall or whatever, and it's got a giant hound head, two arms, two legs, and just tons of tails flowing everywhere. And at the end, there's just a solid chunk mass that looks like it's for beating something to death. And in its stomach, there's this giant maw just sitting there, and it just reaches for you. I need you to make a quickness check.
And a penalty.
It just swoops you up and just starts shoving you into its stomach as it's just eating you. Alright, you just ran from this horrible, horrible situation. You're in the forest.
Do I hear anything behind me?
You hear tons of screaming, and then it just dies down.
I guess after a moment, I will slow, panting in the mist, try to take shape of what's around me, and perhaps decide which direction I should go in. Are there any indications or clues of a place that might be better?
Cause no, there's nothing. You can just see the woods. You roughly know where you came in here, but you're not exactly sure.
I guess I'll just go in a different random direction if I have no idea of where to go.
Make a navigation check.
That's a null and a failure.
You're bumbling along through the forest just trying to get away from what you saw. And you come across a little clearing. Inside this clearing, there's...
If it's a big tree, I gotta make another sanity check.
No, it's a pile of branches. They all are a bunch of big, sturdy branches all lined up kind of teepee style. And across it, there are just tons of ruin across all the branches. Like weird-looking, carved out, filled in with maybe silver or something like that. And then there's a woman laying there, holding her belly, leaning against these branches.
Oh, God.
She's against the teepee.
She's kind of leaning against these branches.
Is the teepee hollow, down. Or is it...
Like... Yeah, it's hollow. It's just a bunch of branches all stacked against each other and perfectly aligned in such a way. Each of these branches is kind of carved out with weird runes, and they're filled in with this kind of silver or something. And so if something's written in them, you don't know what it means at all. But when you touched it... Hold on. Your mouse. Is he good?
Yeah, he's good.
When you touched it, the whole thing lit on fire. You thought you were going to ignite also, but nothing happened. And this beam shot up, and just, you can just see. You, and only you, can see this beam shooting straight up from them. You can add a bonus to any stat of your choice. You also lost all hunger and thirst you felt. It's gone. You feel fine in that department. It did nothing to your labor.
Okay.
She's leaning against this weird ruined branch teepee.
Oh God, it's coming. Oh God. Oh God.
She looks like she's in intense pain.
What's coming?
Oh, my beautiful baby girl. Oh, the baby's coming.
What's inside this teepee?
Nothing.
It's empty inside?
Yeah, it's just sitting on a patch of dirt, basically. There's nothing inside.
Have you just gotten here?
I got here a few minutes ago. I need some help. I need some help. The baby's coming. Oh my God. Please, please, mister. Please, I can't do this myself.
I guess I'll help her.
Okay.
I guess I'm going to start performing like the doctors I've seen on TV.
She's just having contractions right now.
You've got to stay calm. You have to keep breathing. Keep trying to breathe in a rhythm. Every time you feel a contraction, you have to push.
Okay. Where's Dale? Where is he?
This is. I'm sorry, but there's no such thing as Dale here. I don't know who Dale is. He's not here. Yeah, I'm here. Dale's not here.
I need my husband, Dale. I need.
I'm just gonna stand up and like just throw my hands up and just leave.
You're just gonna leave?
I don't give a shit. Like the things that have happened so far, like
yeah.
What the fuck? Fuck this.
Okay.
Oh God!
I'm gonna just start walking away.
Please!
No!
Okay, he yells no and just wanders off.
Alright, with every contraction I'm just gonna start pushing.
Your werewolves, I guess. You've been wandering. You took the left path as you came in. You saw a bunch of blood. It was horrible. You ended up walking down a path, and you just started wandering through this forest, and this weird, unnatural forest. There's no foliage. You've seen weird lights off in the distance, but you paid no heed to that. But you started hearing some crying, and you came across this field. In the middle of this field, there's this teepee-looking structure, a bunch of sturdy branches all lined up and pounded around into a teepee over just empty dirt. Each of these branches has just silver runes like carved into it. And there's a woman leaning against it.
Oh, it's coming!
What's coming, my dear?
Oh, my God, my child. My beautiful baby Samantha's coming. I need some
Samantha,
help.
Samantha, that is a beautiful name. How can I help you?
It's coming. It's coming. I need help. It's coming.
What do you need me to do? I'm all hands.
You need to help.
Some of the hands.
I need you to help me deliver this.
Okay, I'll deliver.
Yeah, no, it's...
You know what? I'm going to cast the spell to help ease her pain.
You know what? Your pain is really diminished.
just calm down.
He clearly knows what he's doing. Some way, you feel very comfortable.
Oh my god, please. Please, you don't have to help me. It's coming.
Yes, this beautiful baby Samantha. His head is grabbing right now.
This baby just comes out. You're there delivering. It's just crying. You've done this a couple times for whatever reason. And just, you just deliver this baby. You're just so happy. It's, you know, happy.
Do you have anything to cut the umbilical cord?
Let me see my baby Samantha.
You looked at the baby, and where there should be eyes, there's just smooth flesh.
Yes, she's right here.
He hands you the baby, you see there's no eyes, it's just this smooth flesh.
Samantha, oh my.
She's blessed. It's
she is just bleeding.
My baby Samantha, you have to. It's getting... My legs are... Why are my legs cold?
Why are your legs cold? Let's remedy that.
I'm gonna warm touch her legs. One success.
Okay, you don't feel anything.
They're getting so cold,
we'll try moving them around some.
The baby is just crying and crying and screaming.
Let's find something to put over her mouth.
Samantha, please.
I don't need this right now, I'll be honest.
The child stops making noise suddenly.
There, that's much better. Now, can you tell me exactly where we are, where we're going? Anything like that? Okay, I'm gonna go.
She just fades out.
Alright, I'm gonna just keep on walking down the path.
You just finished in this room, beacon soared into the air, and you felt this rush of godliness. Now what?
I want to turn around. And I want to go back out to the branches because I feel like one of those paths will take me back to the light.
Can I have you make a navigation check? Oh, nice.
I have one pass.
You hear something crying off in the distance. Sounds like a child.
Oh, baby. Is that a baby?
It's echoing off the halls everywhere, but you're pretty attuned to this. You've been born to carry a child.
A baby in the light. I'm going towards the sound.
You stumble across this... Are you male or female?
Male.
You stumble across this little boy just crying.
Hey, hi. Hi. Hi.
Hi. I was at the fair.
And now you're here, and you're here in hell with me? Come, little boy, come. Come to me.
Are you here?
Strength in numbers.
Are you here to help me?
No. You listen to me. My mother always told me there's strength in numbers, and you were brought to me, and I was brought to you for a reason.
She got me. I threw the darts at the balloon.
I don't know why we're here either. I don't know why I'm here or why you're here. It doesn't make any sense, but we have to go to the light.
Will you help me? If you don't help me, I'm gonna cry!
No, Mother said that if someone's crying, we should just let them cry. Mother said I can't give you what you want because I'm gonna be spoiled.
I hold up this lollipop. Two-fisted lollipop.
It's one of those big...
It's a big...
You get at the fair, it's way too big.
Do you want some?
No. I don't want to take candy from a baby, because Mother said that would make babies cry.
I don't know what to do.
Little boy, if you want to come with me...
I've been drunk and asleep for a while.
But you have to listen to your own heart, because Mother said you have to listen to yourself. So if you need to go pee or anything like that, we can do that. But if you want to come with me, you can come with me.
I peed a while back. On accident.
That's okay. That's okay.
You
If you want to come with me, you can come.
Yeah.
But I'm leaving right
now. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
We're gonna keep walking. We're gonna keep walking. Do you wanna sing a song? Do you know any songs? No. Not my boobs. Not my boobs. You can't grab my boobs. No. No.
I know a song.
Let's sing a song.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, playing your new song.
No, no, so Mother said that was devil music. Row, row your boat was fine.
Merrily down the stream. Merrily, merrily.
Do you have a mother?
I had a mother.
What do you mean had?
I was at the fair. There was a man, and he gave me this lollipop, and now I'm here in the dark.
You've been alone in the dark for a while, you can't see anything.
There's nothing. Well, just you.
Good you thing just... that we have my flip phone, and we're gonna keep on going, because Mother said she just gotta keep on keeping on.
Keep on trucking.
Exactly. Exactly, little boy. What is your name, little boy?
Percival. Oh my god.
What a very thoughtful name. What a very thoughtful name. I'm Miss Guinevere. You can call me Gwenny.
Gwenny. This is the first time I heard your name. How did we get home? There were shadows and there was green and there was awful things and noises.
No. Mother says, if you don't have anything nice, you don't say anything at all. We're going to keep on going. If you'd like to come with me, I would love your company.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go.
Let's go. Here, take my right hand. It's a special hand. And we keep walking.
Make a navigation check.
One pass.
All right, you come into a room, and it's a normal dirty room. Moss and dirt and little pools of condensation here and there. But there's in the corner, with your flip phone, you can kind of see a throne of some sort, a little chair. There seems to be something sitting on the chair, but you can't quite tell. Your phone's just not good enough.
So, my mother would probably think that we should turn around, but my mother's not here. I don't know. I feel like there's something scary.
Mommy!
Okay, so if something was sitting over there, I'm pretty sure that it would...
You hear a very loud noise in the distance.
Okay, something's coming. Hands up! We put our hands up, hoping that it's a sign of, like, a white flag.
Yeah. You don't really hear anything else after that.
It's quiet. There's no light. Do you want to turn around, little boy? I put my hand on his face because I don't know what he's saying. Because I dropped my phone.
You hear him mumble.
Okay. Mother says that if you're ever lost, you need just ask for directions.
She knows everything.
Mother always knows everything. She's a nurse, and she knows what she's talking about.
Me? Everything?
Hello? Sir?
There's no answer. Nothing's even moving.
Sir, I think I saw you sitting in the chair. I think I saw you sitting in the chair. And I think you should answer me because I have a young child with me.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any way we can get to this light?
There's no answer. You don't see any movement? You don't hear anything.
Okay, if you want to rape me, just know. Just know that I'm barren. No, I'm not conceiving any children. And I'm pretty sure I have herpes or HIV or some STD.
She's barrow with herpos.
That you will contract and she will condom.
There's no answer. There's no answer.
I walk up towards the throne. Hold up my lollipop. Towards the throne.
Okay, there's just... It looks like a man is just slumped there. There's no moving. You can't quite see anything unless the light comes.
I keep stepping closer.
But
he wants help.
I don't know. What if he's homeless?
I don't know what that means.
We're in his home. He wants help and candy.
No, he's not answering. I wish that guy was here with that special ball again.
What?
Okay. Let's think. What would Mother do? Okay, Mother is strong. She says it wasn't strong, but I have to take care of you because you're a little boy. And it's a man taking your lollipop.
Yeah, why?
Did he take it?
He gave it to me, and now I want to give it back.
What?
I licked it, and now I'm done.
Okay.
It's too big.
You guys hear another really loud noise.
I walk up full on melee range, and I place the lollipop in the lap.
Nothing happens. It's completely motionless.
Bring the light. Bring the light.
Okay. I get my flip phone, and I bring it up, and I'm shining the light on the man slumped in the throne.
Regular clothing, maybe a little dated, maybe 80s clothing, but the rest of it is just this complete decaying skeleton. You know, there's little bits of flesh hanging off and hair. And
I pick up my giant lollipop and flip it over and see the bits of awful
old dust. There are disgusting things on it.
I'm done with this, I think. Do you want... No, I'll just...
I put it back in his lap.
Okay. Not the right room. We're gonna keep on going.
You hear a really loud noise. It's...
Where are you going?
The light in here seems to be dimming a bit.
What's happening? I just want to go back.
No, I don't know where back is, but we need to keep going. We always go to the right. To the right.
I latch on koala style to her leg.
Make a navigation check, please.
Okay.
And a speed check at minus two dice.
Okay, so navigation is three pass, fail.
Wait, you got three passes on the navigation?
Yes.
Okay, this is slow going, and you hear some horrible noise just right behind you, and you start to smell the weirdest odor. You've never smelled anything like this, and your phone starts to just die off. It's on. It's got like half battery, but it's pretty it's good. But it just starts to just giving. Everything is dimming. And you hear this horrible ruckus in the room you just left. You come across hallways and hallways until you finally come into another room. You know, your light starts to act up again. It starts to light normally, and there's just a ton of masks on the wall. You walk into this room, and you just see mask everywhere.
I run up.
Wow!
And I run up, and I grab one off the wall, and I put it on.
Look! You're my new mommy, and I'm my new me!
Roll a die.
One.
The match just falls to the ground with a pile of dust. You're the pile of dust. Make a sanity check.
Pass.
For some reason, you've seen enough. This doesn't bother you.
Okay. Can I just be drawn to one of the masks and just not put it on, but just hold it?
Sure.
Okay.
You just started wandering, and you know, the forest is difficult. You can't tell where you're going. You can't tell what's going on. You kind of stumble into this clearing. Another man shows up. He kind of stumbles in at the same time from the other side. And you two see each other.
Hello there.
I'm going to just keep going.
Which way?
Just past him.
You're just going to ignore him?
I don't care about him.
Okay, this man just walked past you.
Alright. I'm going to keep going.
Alright, you earmuffs. I hate you two.
Nobody has helped me.
Whoa! I said hi. What am I supposed to do?
I guess I've lost two sanity points.
That's fine. That's fine. Okay. Okay, you're wandering around again. Make a navigation check.
1612.
You basically are wandering in a circle again, and you find yourself back at that teepee.
Is the woman still there?
Oh, she's there. She's just dead. She's dead, and she's holding this child. The child's also dead. And the child does not have eyes. It just has smooth flesh over it.
Does she look human?
Yeah, she looks human. Child looks human except for just smooth flesh instead of eyes.
I'm going to go over to their bodies. Everything seem appropriate? Does it smell not...
It's very fresh. You just saw her.
I'm going to start indulging my dark desire.
You stumble into a clearing. There's a weird teepee set up. perhaps covered in runes, silver runes.
Mm-hmm.
There's a dead woman there. She's holding a child. From where you walk in, they're motionless. And there's just this man. He looks like he's eating her.
Jesus Christ!
I'm gonna turn and look, and with my deadest eyes possible.
Well, hey, buddy, hey! I don't want any trouble, alright? Right?
He's holding a butcher knife. He's clearly, like, cleaning pieces off.
I'm gonna start backing away from where I came. It's cool, man. Don't look. It's cool. Don't want to hurt anybody.
Okay, you're just gonna back off?
He backs off.
You're just gonna go back to...
Just go back to what I was doing.
Okay, yeah. As you back off, he just looks like he ignores you and just kind of goes back.
I guess I'll try some baby, too.
You see him reach for the child and just cut off, like, a leg and just start eating.
I'm gonna see if...
You have to make a sanity check. Just straight up.
That's...
We're just gonna start with that. This is the most awful thing you've seen so far.
No.
First of all, you lose a sanity. All
right.
This completely enrages you. You've never seen something so base, so evil, so wrong.
Hey, man, what the fuck?
I'm going to turn around with my knife.
How long you been here?
What the fuck you do? You
haven't been here as long as I have.
I'm going to start slashing at the air.
You're eating a baby?
Far away is
he? He's maybe 15 feet.
What does he look like?
I don't know. What do you look like?
I'm a man in his mid-50s. Looks fairly disheveled. He's got slightly yellow-colored eyes tinted.
And it looks like he has any weapon.
You don't see anything.
I'm going to start chasing him with this butcher knife.
He's running at you with a knife.
I'm preparing to do something to try and disarm him and punch him.
Okay. I guess you two are just going to make opposed fight checks. Paul, you're going to get a plus one bonus because you have a knife.
Zero.
A 5 and 2 fails.
He just swings this butcher knife and just sticks it right into your arm. You take damage.
Oh!
It hits into your bone and it's just completely stuck. He just loses grip on it and it's just stuck in your arm.
I'm going to remember all the Jean-Claude Van Damme movies I've ever seen in my life, and I'm going to try to do a palm jab right into his nose.
Okay, I need both of you to make speed checks.
No.
2 successes.
Make your fight check versus his fight.
Just 2?
Yeah, you don't have your knife. It's in his arm.
A success and a fail.
Okay, yeah, he completely dodges it. Yeah. You just whiff, and he's got the upper hand. You can attack him. You get plus one bonus.
Well, I'm taking out this knife, and I'm swinging it back at him. I'm tired of this. I've had to deal with so much shit in my life already. I've lost everything. Fuck this, I'm not dying from a fucking baby eater.
Alright, swing. So you get plus one from the knife and plus one from him just completely whiffing. All right. Successes. You're going to make a fight check also.
One pass.
Okay, you're trying to swing the knife at him, but he blocks it enough.
Look, man, you better back off. I don't want to deal with any of this shit.
He's holding your knife. He's bleeding from his arm pretty heavily.
I'm going to run away. Looks into pretty the forest. Tasty.
Okay, he starts running. Are you going to chase him or anything?
No, I'm going to tear off some of my clothes and tie up where I got cut.
Okay, you bolt into the woods. I need your earmuffs.
coward cannibal. The guy that will last the longest.
Jesus Christ, where did I walk into?
Okay. You're sitting here in the clearing, just like tying your wounds. You walk into this clearing. You've been here before. You've just been going in circles again. You find that teepee again where that pregnant woman was. You see her sitting there? What?
Was.
But she's still there. Mostly. You see a woman lying there holding her child, but like the child's missing a leg. It's kind of laying to the side. It looks like somebody's been maybe chewing on it. There is some pieces of her flesh just cut off from her leg. And there's a man bandaging himself over at the side. He looks like he's bleeding pretty heavily from the arm, and he's just wrapping a bandage.
Hello.
Hey. Whoa. Hey.
Hi.
Hi. You.
Pardon?
You didn't see that other guy, did you?
He was just stomping about.
He was eating that woman and her baby.
That woman and her baby?
He was eating them. He stabbed me.
He stabbed me? Well, he doesn't sound very nice.
Look, man.
You need to hand me something. Can I help with that?
Please, Yeah, if you could help me.
Where did he stab you?
Yeah, just upper right arm. Up here. And it's just the blade, there's just blood pouring from it. Looks like he's trying to clean up like a pretty big gash. It looks like it's deep. You can see a big split where he's trying to work on it. He clearly needs help. It's very difficult to wrap this by himself.
I'll wrap that for you. I'm remote as tight as I can.
Okay.
Does it still seem like it's bleeding?
No, you're able to wrap it well enough. You're
okay.
Yeah, thank you, man. Thank you. My name's Victor.
Victor?
Yeah.
I'm Phoenix.
Phoenix, that's a... Alright, look, whatever, man. That's cool, whatever. What is this place, man? What is this, punishment?
Not at all. This is a blessing from the gods. What are you talking about?
There's a man who stabbed me.
Get stabbed all the time.
He's eating that's a like woman a and a baby. They were both dead.
Sometimes people get hungry, and there's not much else.
Are
you saying you've never tried human?
No.
Well, this is a sign.
You want me to eat this?
I'm just saying, it's a sign that it's okay. But anyway, if you're not gonna eat, that's fine. To each his own.
Look, man, I need help. Where are we going? I don't know where to go.
I got half failures on my navigation check.
And a success.
And you're trying to lead him?
And I'm trying to, say, where to go.
He points off in a direction that you've never been.
Thanks, man. Do you need anything?
I am not a man that needs.
You sure? I'll help you with anything, man. You help me out.
Well, why don't you come with me?
Okay.
Let's keep on going. This is an adventure.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, buck up, man. It's just a fucking flesh wound.
I'm gonna pull out my AA chip and start rubbing it between my fingers.
Okay.
I've definitely seen those.
You know about the AA chip.
How long have you been?
It's been 2 years sober.
2 years? That's a long time.
Man, I made some mistakes, man. It's just, I learned I was too selfish. I need to help people. I'm learning. It's hard, man.
Well, help me.
Okay.
All right. I don't even know exactly what we're looking for, but we're looking for signs. So it's just us. I think that the dead woman with the baby with no eyes is a sign. I don't understand it yet. The gods haven't explained it yet, but I think...
All right. I'll put the AAA coin back in my pocket and start following it. All right, so you're leading the way.
This is that direction I point.
Okay. You guys start wandering. You come into this giant clearing. It's sitting right in the middle on top of this mountain. It's this giant tree. It's the only tree you've seen so far with any kind of leaves. There's fruit hanging from it. All kinds of colors.
It's the fruit of the gods.
Do we eat some? Is that what we're supposed to do?
I don't see why we wouldn't eat some. It's a gift.
Okay. Which one do you want?
There's black, blue, red, green, yellow.
I don't know, man. I don't know which one to have.
I'm gonna have blue.
I will get a blue one for him.
Okay, you pull down a blue one. The second you pluck it, another one just...
Thank you.
Okay? You're not hungry at all. You take one bite. You don't even finish the fruit. You take one bite. You're not hungry.
Wow, this is the most satisfying fruit I've ever had.
Wow. I guess I'll get one.
Yeah, see? Things are looking up, man.
All right, I'll take one and take the same one from...
Is it going to grab the same spot?
Yeah, from the same spot.
Okay, yeah, you're not hungry at all. You're just... Every ounce of hunger you felt is gone. One bite.
Wow.
These will come in handy. Let's grab a few more.
Okay, yeah, sure. I'll grab a couple more. All
right. Okay. You're grabbing just blue ones, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to do another navigation check.
Two successes.
You come up on a wall. You feel like this is where the forest pushes up against those labyrinths and catacombs you saw when you were being lured. There's just a solid door there.
A solid door?
Yeah, it's just this big, solid-ass looking door.
All right, let's walk in.
Okay. Try opening it. It looks like it hasn't been opened in a while.
Okay.
All right, yeah. I'll help him.
Okay. I guess both of you make a strength check.
One success.
No successes, one failure.
Okay, you guys just both bang against it, nothing. It's not budging. Both kind of have a sore shoulder.
All right, well, let's just keep on walking along this wall. It'll take us to another.
Okay, man, you're the boss, man.
Okay, you're going to walk along the wall? Okay, make a navigation check.
Two successes.
You're following the wall, and there's a bunch of growth that you can kind of move around it and keep following the wall. You come to a point where there's a stream, and it looks like it's just running straight under the wall. It's a solid wall going a little hole, and the stream is just running. It's coming from somewhere. The water looks relatively normal. Maybe a little dirty.
Should we get any string or anything like that?
Look, I can... I'll just tear off a piece of my shirt. Here's some string.
He exposes a pet.
Well, no, I figure we'll probably need something longer. Why don't you go under, carrying the string, and then when we get to the other side, give three strong tugs.
Okay. All right.
Go under?
Yes. Just going under the wall.
Oh, you want him to go inside?
Yeah.
You want him to go under in the stream under the wall?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so you're going to step into the stream?
Absolutely.
And you're gonna hold on the other end?
Yeah.
Is this making this clear?
Yes.
And how long is this strip?
You
can stand roughly up near the wall. The stream is probably...
Let's make it like a 15-foot.
Okay. Plus, you just unravel a bunch, show sick abs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just unravel a bunch around your shirt.
Yeah.
You're able to fashion, you know, with a bunch of tears or whatnot and knots. You're able to fashion a 15-foot strip. The stream's probably, you know, a good 10 feet wide. I guess so. The water looks like it's moving, it's not terribly fast, but, you know, it looks like it might get deep. It's wide enough.
Yeah, and you know, if you get to the end of the string and it isn't far enough, just swim on back.
Okay.
Alright. You just get in the stream, and I need you to make a strength check.
There's no successes.
He stands in the stream and looks at you and goes, like, I got this. And all of a sudden, just his feet are taken. They just get sucked under. You just get yanked. You're right up against the wall. Right at the edge holding this string.
I'm gonna let go.
Okay. you feel the tug all of a sudden and you let go.
I guess I'm gonna start walking up that stream.
You're gonna walk up the stream?
Yeah, I'm not like walking in it. I'm just walking away from the wall since I can't cross it.
Make a navigation check.
Two successes.
Okay. I mean, it's pretty easy to figure out where you're going whenever you're gonna walk up the stream. You're walking up the stream and you stumble across a man that looks like he's maybe drinking for a little bit. He's just sitting there leaning over it.
How does that taste?
You know, it's not bad. It actually tastes a little bit like double stuffed Oreos.
I don't know. Are you hungry?
No.
All right. I don't know. I see a man drinking.
Oh my god, I'm just having a ball.
So, what are you doing?
Boy. What was I doing? I was looking for the way to the center of this place.
Oh, you want to find the center? That's exactly where I'm going. Why don't you follow me?
Okay, sure.
All right.
What's your name?
I'm Phoenix. What's yours?
Harry Henderson.
That sounds fantastic.
Yeah.
I mean, okay.
How you doing? Do you know why we're here? How we ended up here? What's going on?
Oh, we were sent by the gods. It's fine.
Okay, I agree with you.
Navigation check, yo.
Yes, sir.
No successes.
All right, perfect. You're wandering. You just come across this teepee. You've never seen this before. Mm. It's a bunch of just big, sturdy branches. We're talking a couple inches thick. Just all leaned against each other, teepee style. There's a bunch of silver running through them and have weird archaic runes. There's a woman laying against it, holding a child. They're both dead. The child's leg is on the ground nearby. The woman's leg has been cut up. Looks like something may have been eating it. There's a little blood over in the distance.
Yeah, apparently a man was eating her. Yeah, I helped deliver the baby, took off, and then came back and...
You know, I saw that guy.
Yeah, you saw him?
Mm-hmm. I saw him eating her.
Oh.
He was creepy looking.
Yeah, I saw him too.
You remember, you watch movies at all?
No.
Okay, well, never mind. Yeah, he was eating her. He was eating her and it was gross.
Yeah, that...
I saw it.
Yeah, I mean, I see the remains. It looks kind of nasty, but, you know, sometimes.
What are we doing?
I'm about to make a sanity check.
That's a failure.
No successes.
No successes?
No successes.
Okay. You both feel semi-drawn to this this teepee. Something about it.
Hey, you know, you in particular,
you feel kind of like a magical aura about it.
Yeah, let me test this.
I heard a thing or two about this place. I've studied this place for many, many years, and first person who goes in that teepee when it's all charged up like this actually gains a lot of knowledge.
It's not very big. You can't actually fit in it.
Right, well, I mean, just touching it, you know, becomes, you become, like, practically like a library unto yourself.
A library?
A library of the arcane magics.
Yeah, so why don't you try this? I'm already a library.
Here's the thing. I can't quite do that.
Harry?
Yes?
I feel like you're lying to me right now. I feel like you're preparing a lie. What's that about?
Well, I mean, I don't know how to address that kind of hostility, Frank. Phoenix. No, I'm not lying to you, man. I just heard legends and stuff, and I'm not really into the whole arcane magics thing, so you seem like the kind of guy who wants to be a wizard, or maybe wants to advance your knowledge of the arcane.
Who wants to be a wizard?
Who doesn't want to be a wizard? I mean, me. I don't. I would hate to be a wizard.
Yeah, well, why don't you try this? I get an aura for you.
What if I get a curse or something?
Oh, you don't get a curse.
How do you know that?
You'll get a library of knowledge. You said so yourself.
Yeah. But I think you have to be qualified, you know.
I think you're qualified. As an already a wizard.
Here's the thing. When I was a young man. Listen.
Touch it.
Let me tell you a story about my youth. When I was a young man, I applied to be a CPA for a big accounting firm. And I don't even have a graphing calculator. Like I don't even know what goes in the little boxes, but I applied. And they saw right through it. Another time, I applied to be a blackjack dealer, and I used both hands, and I was, like, fumbling cards everywhere, and the Indian guys were like, what are you doing here? Why are you wasting our time?
Yeah, I heard about it. You're like Harry Potter.
Well?
You're stuck at all these other things. This right here. The American dream.
Here's the thing. Here's a teepee. Speaking of Indians. Here's a teepee brimming with arcane knowledge, right?
Right.
You just said you're a qualified wizard. Why not send the best qualified man?
Yeah, that's you. I'm a wizard, you're a man.
How does that mean? I seriously just sit at home and watch 30 Rock all day. Like
I deal with liars all the time. I'm just gonna go.
You're gonna go?
I'm gonna go.
So we're breaking up then?
Yes.
Okay.
It's been a wonderful relationship and I have no regrets.
Okay. Well, that's healthy. Just so you know, there's a door down the hallway with a big gold keyhole.
Uh-huh.
I have the key in my possession.
All right.
It could lead out of here.
Let's go.
Well, the problem is you just said you didn't want to hang out with me.
That's fine.
So
let's go.
Well, no, it's not fine for me.
No, we'll go through that door.
Phoenix. Phoenix, it's over. Phoenix, it's over.
Alright. I'm gonna cast a spell at him. Okay. I'm gonna try to make his head explode.
That's gonna require some significant successes.
It's like no successes to me. It looks like two ones to me.
You're talking to him.
Listen, key's for me.
He starts focusing on you, and then his head explodes.
Scanners, good movie.
Just watch a child disintegrate. You're.
Wait, did that happen?
What? Yeah, you watched him walk up with the mask on and just collapse into a pile of dust.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah, that happened. Then you grabbed a mask and started holding it. Nothing weird happened. You have a mask. All right, what are you doing?
Well, I was drawn to this mask, but I had decided before getting the mask to continue towards the light.
Okay, even though you're in a completely different room and you dodged that horrible noise, you heard all those horrible things, had that weird child with you, whatever, you can still, for some reason, even through all these walls, through everything, you can still see that beam you saw earlier.
Oh, okay.
It's just shooting straight up into the sky.
Okay. So I can still see the beam.
Yeah, you can still see it. It'll help you navigate a little too if you
want. Oh, okay.
Wherever you are, you can't seem to escape it.
Can I just put this mask on to see if it helps me?
Sure, roll a die.
Okay. One?
Yeah, just one.
Okay. It's one.
You turn into a pile of dust. Make a navigation check.
As I'm making that navigation check, I'll start singing.
What are you singing?
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Okay. Jesus loves you more than you will know.
Are you singing it loudly or quietly?
To myself. Two successes.
Okay.
1-6.
You come across another little tiny clearing, maybe like a 10-foot wide clearing. It's a rough round circle here in the forest.
Mm-hmm.
You've been wandering it, and there is just this pit in the ground. It's filled with some kind of liquid. All around that pit, there are just these weird silver runes. You feel like you've seen this before. that teepee.
Teepee. So I still have my femur.
Yes, I forgot you had a femur, but you still have it. You no longer have your knife, though.
Can I get behind a tree nearby and crouch?
Yeah.
And wait.
Sure.
I don't want to look directly at the pit, but I want to wait and see if anything happens around here.
Okay. You're wandering around through the forest after that weird encounter with that other guy.
Yeah, yeah.
And you happen upon a little clearing, roughly 15 feet wide, 10 feet wide in places. And there's this kind of this weird, very spherical pool right in the center. Around it, there's a bunch of strange runes. You've seen them before. You saw them not long ago when you saw that teepee.
These pools? I've seen these pools?
No, you've seen the runes.
The runes. Huh.
Yeah, it's just this pool. It's just this sunk, you know, this little dip, and it's just filled with some kind of liquid.
Well, I don't think I want to mess with that. It seems like a bad idea. I have this key, and I'd really like to find the door with the keyhole. So I guess I'm going to try and walk beyond it.
Okay. Headphones. You watch this man walk by. He's rubbing this key. He looks at the pool, kind of, and then walks off.
What does he look like?
I honestly have no idea.
Okay. Does he have any item that I like? Does he have?
He's holding a key. He's rubbing.
He's not holding a weapon.
No, you don't see any weapon.
I guess I will just simply start following him.
You headphones. Make a navigation check.
No successes.
You stumble across a clearing. There's just this mound, and there's this giant tree sitting here.
Hello?
This tree is the only tree you've seen so far with any
leaf. Wow.
It's got tons of fruit hanging from it. Fruit are all different colors. We're talking colors. Black, blue, red, green, and yellow. All hanging from it.
Black, blue, red, green, and yellow. Wow, those look tasty.
Oh, they all look delicious.
Man, maybe not the black one. Man, this looks like maybe where I need to be. This looks like maybe where I need to be hanging out for a while.
Okay.
I'm going to reach up and I'm going to grab the green fruit.
Okay.
I'm going to take a bite.
All right. It's probably the most delicious fruit you've ever had.
God.
You feel it. It's not really filling.
Hello?
Know, like most fruit.
You got to try this. Mm.
It's not filling like all fruit. It's just, but it is juice and sweetness. Oh, you man. Love it. This is delicious.
Wow.
You probably want another.
I think I want another one of these greenies.
All right, headphones. You've seen this before. You come back across this clearing. This giant fruit tree is here. The one tree you've seen in this entire place with any leaves.
Mm-hmm.
And also it's bearing tons of fruit. The guy you've been following, he stopped here.
Mm-hmm.
He started grabbing these green fruits, and he ate one. He looked like he was enjoying himself a ton, and he just grabbed another and started eating.
Does anything happen?
No. He's just eating the green fruit.
He's only eating the green fruit, but you say it's of multiple colors?
Yeah, there are black fruits, blue fruits, red, yellow, green. Yeah, that's it.
I'm going to see what colors he eats and what reaction he gets based on them.
He's just eating green fruit. You keep watching, he's just grabbing a green fruit and eating it. And he is enjoying himself. You can tell he really likes this fruit.
Oh, I'm just going to wait.
He looks pretty vulnerable, if that's where you're going with this.
I'm
going
to wait, because I also am very curious about what happens with this tree.
Okay.
You want me to do earmuffs?
Yeah, just earmuffs. Even though you're watching, I want to go over this with him first. Then look.
Do I really need earmuffs now?
All right, fine. All right, you've eaten like three green fruits. They don't seem to be very filling, but you are enjoying them.
Man, I can't get enough of this.
Oh,
I just
awesome.
Want to be here forever.
The second you pluck one from the tree, a new one grows. Just.
I mean, I'm living in pleasure. I'm happy. Why would I want to be anywhere else?
Well, I can't tell you.
No, I'm just going to keep on going.
Okay. You just keep eating green fruit?
The red one's kind of cute. Kind of piquing my curiosity a little bit.
Oh, the
what if
ones?
It's better?
I can't tell you. I can't remember.
I think I'm going to reach up and grab a red.
You're going to grab a red fruit?
Yeah, I'm going to grab a red fruit.
Okay. Paul, I'm going to need you earmuffs.
He looks like he already is.
He's not. Earmuffs. Completely.
I was being a bastard.
Sorry.
Bust.
Yeah, you grab the red fruit, and you start eating it. The first bite is very, very sweet, but as you keep eating it, it's just getting bitter, more bitter, and more bitter. This isn't good.
I miss green.
In fact, it's making me really angry. You've got this weird rage
building up inside you.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what you're going to do.
I don't like what's happening.
You don't know what you're going to do, but if you can unleash this on something, anything, you will.
I'm going to look around.
Roll two dice.
Six and a two.
Hello?
Can you roll two dice?
That's a six and a three.
You don't see anything. You don't see anything at all. But there are a lot of weird noises. You hear weird noises echoing off the walls, the trees. There's some weird-ass screaming.
I'm going to grab the red fruits and start smashing them together.
Okay?
Yeah, I'm pissed.
All of them?
I want all the red fruits.
Every ground you grab, just...
I'm going to keep... I want them gone.
What's up?
You're watching him for a bit, and he's just eating green fruit after green fruit after green fruit.
Sure.
And then...
I'm dead inside, though.
He suddenly reaches over, and he's looking at the green fruit, and he kind of sets it down. And he looks up, and there's a red fruit hanging near him, so he grabs it, and he just starts eating it. And you can tell he's just not enjoying it. He takes a bite, and he's like, and then the more he eats, he's like, oh. And he throws it down. He gets this really evil look on his face, and he's looking around everywhere. He scans by your place, and you duck down and up.
Oh, man.
He's looking everywhere, and he just starts grabbing the red fruit. He's just smashing it.
Fruits?
Another one just pops up the second he grabs it. He just pulls it down, smashing, smashing, smashing.
That's what's happening now.
That's what he's doing.
I guess I'm going to try to, escape.
You're going to just wander off somewhere else? You're going
to
leave.
I want to go back to the fruit if I can later, but I feel like this man is dangerous.
Okay. So you're not waiting here. You're taking off, but trying to get back here.
Like if I'm up against the first tree in the meadow that leads to the big tree, I want to move back three trees.
Okay, you're still watching, but you're backing.
I want to watch him.
You're just.
I'm pissed, dude.
Pull down, smash it. You're yelling. You're screaming. You're just smashing fruit.
Love it.
But nothing's new. Nothing new is happening. But you keep smashing.
Yeah, yeah.
And juice is spraying all over. Mm-hmm. You're covered in red fruit juice, and the more you're covered, the more you're angry.
Yeah, yeah.
The angrier you get, this isn't doing it for you. You know, you've smashed enough, and you've gotten so angry.
Yeah, yeah. What other colors are around?
You had the green and the red. So there's black, blue, and yellow.
I noticed the yellow glowing like the sun. The sun I remember from my other life.
It's very brilliant yellow.
I remember being warm in the sun as a child, going to the beach with my parents, and I reach up and I reach for the sun.
Okay, you grab a yellow fruit. It's very warm. Mm. It's actually surprisingly warm.
Cut the berries.
Oh, it's kind of calming you down a bit.
I nuzzle it a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I see the slight fuzz on it, and I pet it. And then I take a big old bite.
Okay, you take a big old bite, and the second you do, you just start dissolving.
Ah, shit.
The earth is just taking you in.
I feel strangely calm and content.
Oh, no, you're going to love your new life.
I spent an entire life, 44 years, doing everything I could to lie to everyone I found. This is the first truth I've ever discovered.
You are just watching. You're just pulling fruit down the fruit.
Random fruits or the same kind of fruit?
No, red fruit. You just keep pulling it out, smashing. Juice is just flailing all over. And you can tell he's getting angrier, angrier, angrier. And just looking around and just grabs fruit and just smashes it. And then all of a sudden he stops. And he looks up and he grabs his yellow fruit. Pulls the yellow fruit down and he takes a bite. And the second he does, he just starts melting right into the earth. And he's gone.
Oh, I guess I will go up and pick a green fruit and a red fruit and a yellow fruit. And what the hell? What was the other fruit? A purple fruit?
There's a black fruit and a blue fruit.
I'll also pick the black fruit and the blue fruit. I'll take...
You'll want one of each?
Can I take...
They're all pretty good size, maybe twice the size of an apple. They're pretty good.
Oh,
pretty big.
So I can maybe have one of each.
Yeah, you know. You can maybe figure out how to carry more, but you're going to have trouble walking around.
He's melted.
Yeah. Oh, he just...
That was from the yellow fruit.
Yeah, you watched him grab a yellow fruit. You watched it gleam in the sun.
Yeah.
You watched him hold it for a second and look very pleased.
And in my head, I just think, of course. That makes complete sense. That's what would happen with a yellow fruit.
Sure, absolutely.
And I will grab those fruits, and I will move on.
Okay.
Can I make a navigation check to find the best place to go that is not either a horrible woman giving birth to a sightless baby, or a chamber that holds a child who's not a child with Gondar, or whatever it is.
Godzool. This Godzool. Name echoes very clearly. There was a pit in the middle of the forest with liquid in it.
Liquid.
Where you watched him run by?
I watched him run by, that's correct.
Yeah. It was just liquid. It looks like water, maybe. You can't quite tell.
I don't know what might have importance to me now. I'm just simply trying to survive. I know the green fruit appears to be delicious, but I'm not ready to indulge. The red fruit makes someone angry, and the yellow fruit makes someone dissolve. I don't know what the blue and purple fruit do.
Yeah. It's black, not purple.
Oh, I'm sorry. The bloom.
Can I
grab some extra green fruit?
Yeah.
I will try to grab some extra green fruit, maybe.
Sure, you're carrying like three greens and one of the others?
Yes.
Sure. You can shove them. You're wearing like weird cargo shorts. Yeah. You can shove them in.
I was a grad student. Yeah. You know, I was.
You've carried a lot of books before. You know how to carry a couple of fruit.
I'll continue on.
You've been down here maybe 30 minutes or so.
Okay.
You went down the middle path. You just started wandering in the darkness. You managed to avoid the stairs that might make you fall.
Okay.
You just start wandering. You've got your cell phone. You got your Bible.
Yeah.
You're just holding one in one hand, one in the other.
Okay.
You just start wandering. Make a navigation check.
No successes.
You stumble into this room.
Did I come with a group or was it just
me? Oh, it's just you. Okay. You came down by yourself. You saw that trail of blood going one way. You looked the other way and saw a hand lying in the middle of the floor. This is the only way to go. You went down the middle, and you're wandering through the halls, going left, right, left. You're not even sure anymore. You just wander into this room, lighting it with your cell phone. It's just this room of masks. There are two masks on the floor. One with a small pile of dust, and one with a larger pile of dust. Both of them just sitting there.
Okay.
And there are masks lining the wall. There's clearly two masks missing from the wall.
I haven't seen anything terrible up until this point, except for...
No, I mean, you've seen blood, you've seen hands... Multiple hands.
Yeah.
But really, that's it. Nothing more horrifying. You almost tripped over a skeleton on your way in. Gleaming white skeleton. Picked completely clean.
Okay. I'm going to take the dustier mask. One with the bigger pile of dust beneath it.
Okay.
Hold it up and examine it.
Okay. It's a weird mask. It's very wide. Very, you know, it's got a very ovuloid, I guess, head shape for where you put it on.
Okay.
But after that, it's got a lot of flare. Big wing... Coming straight off the top, big wings, and they're just colored in red and yellows. The eyes are painted to look like they're on fire. And there's a little mouth hole slit as well. Black paint just coming down from it.
Like so this is devil stuff. This is clearly
oh, you, stuff. You're not comfortable with it.
Yeah, I'll set it back.
Okay. As you look across the mask, you're not comfortable with any of them.
Okay. You know, I'm gonna draw a little cross in the dust.
Beneath both masks?
Yeah. And then I'll... Just keep going. Just sort of hanging out with these guys.
Make a navigation check.
All ones.
Perfect. You're wandering hall, whatever. You finally turn into this room. You walk into this room and there's a giant pool, almost filling the whole room. It's a big sphere. Inside the sphere, there's this gold, yellow liquid. It just glitters as your light just dances across.
I guess I'm probably thirsty after walking around all those dusty rooms and all that.
It doesn't look...
Like water, it's just...
Liquid. It doesn't look like water.
Okay. Yeah. I'm still going to touch the liquid. I just want to touch it with my left hand.
Okay. Second you touch it, you just feel all of this liquid just suck into your body.
Okay. Okay, well, first thing I'm going to touch is just my cross.
You straighten up? You kind of straighten up, feel the cross, because you're like not sure what's going on, and you just watch it just turn to gold.
Okay.
And it feels heavy. It just feels heavier.
Yeah. All right, so I'm just going to grab it, my cross... And I'm just going to pick up my Bible that now turns to gold.
Mm-hmm.
My phone that turns to gold. So, okay. Soon. And I guess I'll just keep walking.
Everything you're touching is just gold. Everything you're carrying just starts feeling heavier.
Okay, I guess I'm going to drop the phone.
Yeah, you're getting weighed down.
And I guess I'm going to set down the Bible, too. But I'm going to, set it down.
It's pretty heavy. It's thick. Big, and it's just solid. You just set it down, it's just clink.
And then I'm going to keep walking.
For navigation.
Well, two failures.
You come across this weird stream running. All of a sudden, this man just shoots through. He's holding on to some weird rope. You've been plummeting through the darkness, just You can't breathe. It's just underwater, plummeting underneath. And then you just break free all of a sudden. And the water is slowed down to a crawl here. Whatever it's hitting, it's just gently drifting. You can stand up. You lose one toe, you know, from choking. You don't see a single thing. You can tell there's a man there who's making noise. You can ask him. You know someone just showed up.
Hello?
You hear it? Yeah. He's coughing, yeah. You can tell someone's there.
Here, can I help you?
You can't see anything. It's pitch black.
Where am I?
Do you have a phone or a light or something so I can help you?
Do I have
a phone? Yeah, oh, you've got your phone on you.
It does it. I guess I'll pull it out if it's not soaked.
Roll a die.
5.
Yeah, it's fine. For some reason, the water hasn't affected it yet.
I guess I turn it on and kind of light up in the direction of his face.
Okay. You can roughly describe yourself.
Okay, so yeah, I'm like a late 30s priest. My head's balding. I'm Caucasian. And I'm just wearing like normal garb, but I have like a golden cross walking over to you.
Are you a priest?
Yes, I am, son. Here, can I help you?
I'll grab his hand and pat him on the back.
Yeah, I'll get up and...
The second he touches you, you just feel a shock through your body. Everything is just stiffening up. You just turn to this gold, just fall over.
Alright, before we start, I want to tell my story.
Tell your story.
Alright. Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
So, I went to Denver yesterday to go see the Pretty Reckless, whatever, you know, like rock metal band, kind of whatever.
Yeah.
So we got into Denver at noon, and we just walked around downtown for like 5 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And then we got to the concert and listened to like the first two opening bands, which was like 3 or 4 hours worth. So I'm on my legs forever, and my knee sucks, as you know. So, like, my knee is just in super pain nonstop. And then the Pretty Reckless come on, and I'm like, I need to go sit down somewhere because my leg just hurts. Like, it's just in so much pain. So I'm like, I'm going to go up to the balcony and just sit because, like, in the balcony of the Fillmore, there's, like, a bleachers section.
Sure.
So I'm going up there, and then they just stop me right away and, like, I don't care if you have a VIP. You can't come up here. Like, you know, people pay for these skybox seats. I was like, oh, shit, that sucks. My leg hurts, and there's, like, no, like, seating unless you're handicapped.
Okay.
So I'm just walking around for a while in here, and then I find a handicapped section, and there's one person there in a wheelchair. And there's, like, security guards, like, walking back and forth, like, you know, making sure nobody goes through. And I was like, I'm going to sit there. And I start to walk by, and this security guard comes up to me and, like, holds up a finger, and he's like, no, you can't do that. And I was like, oh, it's fine, whatever. And so I'm just standing there, hanging out, and then I wait for him to, like, make his loop around. And as soon as he's out of sight, I go and sit down. And my leg feels so good that, like, I'm not, like, standing on it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And the Pretty Reckless come on, and they play one song, and then I pass out.
Oh, shit. Because you were drunk or just because of the pain?
No, just because of the pain, and I was up since like 5 a.m. and it's like at 9 or 10 at night. And so I just pass out, and they play a few songs, and then I wake up and I check my phone, and it's, you know, it's been like 4 or 5 minutes, so they've only played like a song or two. But I wake up and there's just drool hanging out of my mouth, and it's like falling on my shirt. And the security guy, like, looks at me, and I can see in his eyes, he's like, oh, this guy's retarded or mentally handicapped. And so he just lets me stay there. But I realize this, and I was like, oh, no. He knows that, like, I'm here because I'm handicapped. So I just played it up, and I just pretended to be handicapped for the rest of the set. And I just sat there, and, like, I kept, like, thinking to, like, pass out and, like, drool on my shirt so I could stay there so my leg wouldn't hurt. And then they finished, and I went over and I was talking to Gunn, and he's like, Yeah, that's the most womp thing I've ever heard.
Yeah, that's so womp.
That's funny, man.
That's my story.